regreso aquí en Auto 060 y ahora vamos a pasar directamente al inglés. We're going to switch immediately to English in this segment because we have Young Slowly from Chevrolet who is going to talk about football, soccer for us. How are you, John?
I'm well, and yourself, Javier?
Excellent. Thank you very much for your time and sharing this information from Chevrolet and soccer.
Yes, my pleasure.
Which in our world we call it football, right? But in
football,
America,
that's what we call it too. Only us Americans that think that football is played with a pigskin on on a field. So.
Well, yeah, but in any case. Soccer or football, whatever we want to call it, it's a big part of Chevrolet, believe it or not. And I saw this announcement about a very cool initiative that you guys are doing in Detroit. Can you talk about that, please?
Yes, we are the founding sponsor, along with an organization called One World Football, to globally distribute 1.5 million virtually indestructible soccer balls to children in need around the world. And one of our very local initiatives with One World Football is actually taking place here in our very own market of Detroit, actually tomorrow, April 27th, in partnership with Big Brothers, Big Sisters here locally. So we're very excited about that.
Well, that's great. And as I told you before, we went in the air, I play soccer a lot, and I remember when I was a kid, I grew up in Mexico, and we were always struggling with balls because we had to buy many, and they would go over the fence, and then the neighbors were giving it back, and it was always a struggle. So this brought us some good memories and bad memories too. But in any case, like, soccer is always being close to me, so I think this is great. So can you talk a little bit about this indestructible ball? What is it made for?
The beauty of this ball is that, like we say, it is virtually indestructible. You can step on it, puncture it, play on the roughest terrain, and the ball always continues to just reinflate itself. It doesn't need a pump. It doesn't need air, and lasts for, years and years and years. We can't take credit for it. The inventor and founder of the ball itself is a gentleman by the name of Tim Yonigan, and he was inspired by watching children in unfortunately very poor countries and war-torn countries playing with balls that they made out of trash or rags, all strung up and wadded up. The spirit of these children is they want to play and they'll find a way to play. So he wanted to come up with a ball that would last and they'd be able to play with. So, even in your own personal story, when you said, growing up in Mexico, the ball would go or it would go flat or whatever the case may be. What's the beauty of this is that is how ingenious and innovative and indestructible that this ball is. It's made out of a unique foam material. And it's been, tested over and over, and it just continues to bounce back, just like the spirit of the kid.
Yeah, that's great. And actually, even though it's not directly developed by General Motors or Chevrolet, I think they're going to find a way to put some of these in the car, because it sounds like a pretty cool technology that might maybe be applied in some parts of the car.
Yeah, well, what's very interesting is on our social channels, you can go to our YouTube channel, ChevroletFC, .com, and get to our social channels. We actually took the ball to our vehicle testing facilities and put it through some of the same tests and validation that we put our vehicles through, heat testing, cold testing. We crushed it, and the ball continues to just bounce back and bounce back. So we've tested it to our standards, and it's lived up to those for us as well. So it's pretty marvelous.
Well, that's pretty cool. So, and you said this is an initiative that is going to benefit kids all over the place, but you started in Detroit?
Well, it's actually, we did not start in Detroit. Oh. It will benefit children all over the world. Over the next 3 years, we're committed to distribute 1.5 million footballs to children in need around the world. We brought it locally here to home in Detroit just this year, and we'll start a program, like I said, with our local chapter of Big Brothers and Big Sisters. And we'll donate over 1,300 balls here in the Detroit area through our Detroit public school system with the help of Big Brothers, Big Sister, and then another organization called the Police Athletic League.
That's excellent. That's very cool. I appreciate Chevrolet's efforts because, as I said, soccer is, or football is, very close to me. And another thing, Chevrolet has been involved in football in the past, in the recent months or years, because you already have a big sponsorship for one of the most popular teams in the world.
That is correct. So as of May of 2012, Chevrolet signed on as an exclusive sponsor of Manchester United, and we're very, very proud because as of this past Monday, they clinched their 20th title in the English Premier League. So we are now, can say, we sponsored the number one team in the English Premier League, and the number one team in the world, with probably the largest fan base globally, with over 659 million fans around the world. So we're very, very proud and excited and happy for our sponsorship with Manchester United.
That's great. Congratulations on that one.
Thank you.
Can we talk a little bit more about the global program? And you said you're going to donate one and a half million balls,
yep,
around the world. But what are the things that is Chevrolet doing to promote soccer and around the world?
Well, like I said, we have our Manchester United sponsorship. We have our One World Football sponsorship. And then in select markets, there may be affiliations with national teams or local teams as well. I know in Mexico, just a couple weeks ago, or actually last week, our colleagues down there formed a relationship with Team Santos and United Way and One World Football. So Mexico's got a program going on. And I know other, countries around the world also have smaller associations with their local teams.
Yeah, and Chevrolet is very big in around the world, obviously. But in Mexico, I remember they have a big plant, San Santos, which is in Torreon. It's that might be closer to one of your plants there, and maybe that's the reason to do this program there too.
Definitely. That's one of the underlying reasons for that program. Yeah.
Well, that's great. So, as you said, all these balls are going to be rolling down in Detroit and some other parts around the country. So that is absolutely great. Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.
Is there anywhere you mentioned the YouTube channel, but is there any other places where our audience can look at all these initiatives from Chevrolet and football?
The best place to go would be Chevrolet FC, so for a football club, chevroletfc.com. And if you go there, you can link to our YouTube, Facebook and other channels as well. But if you visit chevroletfc.com, you'll be able to get a sense of all the stuff that we do in the football space.
Excellent. And what about you? Do you play soccer?
I did not play organized soccer. I played neighborhood soccer.
Well, disorganized soccer is sometimes much more fun. Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, I play a little bit still. Unfortunately, I dislocated the shoulder playing in December,
and
I think I'm gonna.
You've got your war battles, your wounds.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna retire very soon from soccer, but active at least. But this is very cool to see a company like Chevrolet developing initiatives in sports that here in the States are not as big, and I think that's very cool because it's a great sport.
Yes, it is. It's definite, and as they call it the beautiful game, and we're very proud to be part of it in many different ways.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Javier.
Gasloli, he is the marketing manager for General Motors around the world and promoting this great initiative. Thank you very much for your time again.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bueno, ahí teníamos a John Gasloli hablando de esta iniciativa increíble de la Chevrolet impulsando el fútbol, nuestro fútbol acá en Estados Unidos y alrededor del mundo con la iniciativa que se llama Chevrolet FC, Chevrolet Football Club. Ellos son, como decía John, desde el año pasado patrocinadores del Manchester United en Inglaterra y tienen esta iniciativa mediante la cual van a donar 1,500,000 de pelotas de fútbol, de balones prácticamente indestructibles, de un material que no se pincha, no se desgasta y realmente beneficia a todos esos chicos alrededor del mundo que tienen esta pasión por el deporte y que lamentablemente, como lo mencionaba él y como a mí me pasó quizá y a algunos de ustedes también les pasó cuando eran chicos en sus países de origen, teníamos los balones y a veces se pinchaba, se perdía, se iba a través de una cerca, caía en la casa de un vecino gruñón que no te la quería devolver. Así que, bueno, una iniciativa más de la Chevrolet para desarrollar esta iniciativa. Y mencionaba él ahí, se lo recomiendo y lo vamos a colocar en nuestra página de Facebook, facebook.com/auto060, un video muy interesante de cómo llevaron este balón indestructible a la prueba, a las pistas de pruebas de la Chevrolet, y la hicieron pasar por todas las pruebas que llevan los vehículos de calor, de frío, de resistencia, de choques, de impactos, y vieron cómo funcionaba este balón, y realmente se volvía a inflar prácticamente solo y seguía creando diversión para los chicos. No se vayan, que cuando regresemos vamos a hablar con Lynette Díaz, que por coincidencia estuvo esta semana aquí en Miami hablándonos de otra cuestión de General Motors, que son las aplicaciones que tiene disponible General Motors en todos sus modelos, especialmente en el Chevy Spark y en el Buick Verano, aplicaciones muy interesantes que van en complemento de lo que hablábamos en el primer segmento del show con Christina Jagger del Texas Transportation Institute sobre cómo estar seguros cuando manejamos en el auto y usamos los teléfonos celulares. No se vayan, esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota. We'll be right back.